In part one of this tutorial, we ran a workspace that was already provided with FME Server. But you'll want to be able to publish your own workspaces to FME Server and run them, so let's learn how that's done. We will review and run a workspace in FME Workbench, publish the workspace to FME Server, run the workspace from the FME Server web user interface, and finally, show the results page. Open the workspace template attached to this article in FME Workbench. It's a straightforward workspace, taking data from a file geodatabase and writing it to the generic format. The generic format is very flexible and allows for the user to decide which format to write to when the workspace runs. Currently, it's been set up to write to Esri shapefile. We can confirm that by taking a look at the output format parameter. Let's run the workspace to make sure it works before publishing it to FME Server. Click File, Publish to FME Server. Click Connection, and then Add Web Connection. First, give your web connection a new name. I've chosen Training FME Server. Enter your server URL, then connect with the username and password. We can use the default author username password. Next, select a repository and workspace name. We'll click on the New button to create a new repository. Enter Server Tutorial for the name. Let's keep the workspace name as communitymapping.fmw. Next, register the workspace with one or more services. The services return translation results in slightly different forms. The data download service returns results as a downloadable zip file. The data streaming service returns results as a data stream. The job submitter service accepts and runs workspace job requests. The KML network link returns a KML network link that can be used in Google Earth. And the notification service allows for event-driven messaging. Check the data download service. You can leave the job submitter checked. Click Publish. The log file should confirm the workspace was successfully published. Now open the FME Server web user interface. Log in with the author username password. Our workspace appears in the Last Published Workspaces section. Click Run Workspace. On the Run Workspace page, select the repository we just created, Server Tutorial. Once you do this, the workspace field below will automatically be populated with the community mapping workspace because it is the only one in the repository. The service dropdown shows the two services we registered this workspace with. Pick Data Download. We'll work with published parameters in the next part of this tutorial. For now, click on Run. We have a successful translation with some summary information and a data download URL. Click on the URL to download the zip file. Then open up the zip file to confirm we have a number of Esri shapefiles as a result of our translation. Now, wouldn't it be great to give the user the choice of which format they want the results in? We'll learn how to do that in the next part of this tutorial.